Hello everyone. Today we are here to solve the hockey puck problem, which was a question one of midterm one. Before that, let's first see Newton's first law, which says an object at rest remains at rest and an object in motion remains in a motion with constant speed until and unless there is a force applied on the body. If there is no force on the body, there is no acceleration. The acceleration of the object depends on the mass of the object and the amount of force applied. We get to know this from the formula: force is equal to mass into acceleration. Whenever one object exerts a force on another object, the second object exerts an equal and opposite force. So that's the third law. This is a question. An ice hockey puck has the mass of 170 grams, enters the goal with a momentum pi. The value is given, and the line. The goal line is also given, relative to the origin. The delta t is 0.4, and the question is, what was the location of the puck when it was hit by the player? We can assume that the friction is negligible. We can solve this by first getting the velocity, which is p initial by mass. We get this thing, velocity is this value, and then we use the position update formula. That is R initial. Basically, this is an altered version of the formula, which basically separates R final is equal to R initial plus velocity into delta t. But because we need R initial, I flipped the equation to get R initial, and this is the R initial, 16.2 minus 6.82. And 0 meters. This is the second question. The player has hit the puck with a constant force for a short time. Delta t is equal to 0.1, which changes only the direction, which and not the speed. If the speed did not change, the magnitude will be the same. Before it was hit, the velocity of the puck was along positive y direction. What is the force? Right? If it did not change, let's first find the magnitude of P, which is this thing, 5.34. And because P final is equal to P initial, this is Newton's first law in action. See, when the force is applied, there is a change in the final momentum. We have all the quantities here, and we just input the formula P final minus P initial by delta T, and we get the answer 46, negative 25, and 25.3 and 0 Newton respectively on the x, y, and z axis. Thank you so much. Have a nice day.